So good morning to all. In today's class, we'll discuss about the time domain description of VSB signal. Time domain description of VSB signal. Now put aside reading time domain description. Time domain description for VSB. Take the VSB modulated wave as S of t. Let us consider VSB modulated wave as S of t. Already you know VSB modulated wave consists of wastage of lower side band and one complete part. So that is one upper side band. So upper side band plus wastage or retrace of lower side band. Already in frequency domain description, we see the frequency response for VSB signal. If you observe that signal, what is the VSB? It is complete one side band, that is only last some part is eliminated. So totally, theoretically it can be say that complete one side band and some part of the lower side band is passed. That is called wastage. Wastage are retrace of lower side band. If you pass lower side band completely, then you pass retrace or wastage of upper side band. That is another way. So therefore, we consider S of t. S of t is a VSB modulated wave. VSB modulated wave containing wastage of lower side band. Wastage of lower side band. And how we generate VSB? From DSBSC signal by passing through it to shaping filter. By passing through it to shaping filter. Already you observe VSB modulators. The block diagram of VSB modulator consists of first block is product modulator. At the output of product modulator, we have DSBSC signal. When that DSBSC signal is passed through wave shaping, that is a shaping filter, then we got VSB modulated wave. Once you observe the block diagram for generation of VSB signal, so this one. At the output of product modulator, we have DSBSC signal. So after generating of DSBSC, then it is passed through sideband shaping filter. We got VSB modulated wave. Now consider the sideband shaping filter transfer function as H of F. Now consider the H of F is transfer function for sideband shaping filter. First, let us take the S of T is a VSB modulated wave. How we got VSB modulated wave? By passing the DSBSC signal through. Through sideband shaping filter, which have the transfer function of H of F, which have the transfer function of H of F. Now, complex of H of F can be considered as so. This is complex of H of F. So you just put envelope symbol at the top. Then how we can write complex of H of F is complex of HUF minus complex of HVF. First note down the expression. After that I deeply tell each parameter. If H of F is a transfer function of sideband shaping filter, then complex H of F, that is H envelope. We put envelope symbol here. HF can be written as HUF complex minus HBF complex. Then note down what is HUF and HBF. Where HUF is complex low pass filter transfer function, which is nothing but band pass filter designed to reject lower side band. So to got VSB signal, first we take a low pass filter. So low pass filter, if we take a complex response, then it acts as a band pass filter, that is it eliminates one sideband completely. So therefore, let us take low pass filter transfer function is HUF, which is a complex low pass filter transfer function, which is nothing but band pass filter to reject lower side band. In VSB there is not completely pass lower side band, we have one complete side band, that is upper side band, and some part of lower side band. Or otherwise you can send in another way, that is complete lower side band and some part of upper side band. In this analysis here we consider some part of lower side band. So for that purpose we take the complex low pass filter, have the transfer function HUF. So from the above expression, HUF is for complex low pass filter, which is nothing but band pass filter designed to reject lower side band. Now take what is the HBF, complex HBF. It is for generation of wastage of lower side band. Why this transfer function is used? That is to generate wastage of lower side band. Here we use filter which have the transfer function of HBF. So now observe the above expression. So totally what is the transfer function for sideband shaping filter? H of F is a transfer function, then complex of H of F can be written as H envelope F. So this means complex, which is equal to how we can get from low pass filter transfer function and from wastage of lower side band. For this here we use some filter. Now if you observe the frequency response, so this is the final response of sideband shaping filter. Before draw this response, first you draw first component, that is for this component. First you draw frequency response for HUF. What is HUF? Complex low pass filter transfer function. So from this response you observe here we pass only one band of frequencies and reject all other frequencies. So therefore it is a frequency response for low pass filter. So complex low pass filter is also acts as a band pass filter. So this is the response for HUF, that is first component. Now draw the response for second component. What is our second component? HVF, Westage transfer function. So this is the Westage transfer function. What is the purpose of Westage? To allow some part of the lower side band and eliminate last part of upper side band. So for this purpose we take a filter with the transfer function of HVF. Now this is the frequency response for second component. If we combine both these responses, then we got final response of sideband shaping filter according to this expression we have this response, that is, it is nothing but HUF minus HVF. Here HUF is a complex low pass filter response transfer function, HVF is a Westage transfer function. By combining these two frequency responses, we got our original final response, which is nothing but sideband shaping filter response, which is represented with complex H of F. Now you draw the frequency response for sideband shaping filter. That is, here we have one complete band, upper side band, which have the bandwidth from 0 to omega, and we have some part of lower side band, which is nothing but FV. So this is the final response for sideband shaping filter. So this is the response for imaginary part, that is out of phase transfer function, that is quadrature response. Take the response of J, quadrature transfer function. Is like signum function. Now coming to analysis, already you know complex low pass filter transfer function HUF is equal to half of 1 plus signum function. Already you know from signals and systems, this is complex low pass filter transfer function. Here we pass upper side band, therefore you represent with HUF. If you take a lower side, then you represent with HL. But here we consider upper side band, therefore we pass upper frequencies. So therefore you represent with HUF. Which is equal to half into 1 plus signum function. At which frequencies? Observe frequency response from 0 to omega. 0 to omega frequency we have this function, otherwise it is 0. So therefore it represents limitations from 0 to omega. The frequency lies between 0 to omega, we have this function, elsewhere it becomes 0. take this as equation number 1. Which one? This one. Take this as equation number 1. H complex F equal to HUF complex minus HVF complex. Take this as equation number 1. Now, substitute HUF. Substitute HUF in equation number 1. In equation number 1. Then we got complex H of F equal to complex H of F equal to half into 1 plus signum function minus complex HVF. Complex HVF. Where the frequency lies? Frequency lies between Westage frequency to omega. Otherwise it becomes 0. Becomes 0. Here, one important point is signum function and complex HVF are odd functions. Odd functions. So, note down one important point. Already you know signum function and HVF, complex Westage function, are odd functions. Therefore, they also contain imaginary values. Here signum function and complex of Westage function are odd functions. Therefore, they may also contain imaginary values. So from that, we can write a new expression that is quadrature, out of phase transfer function can be written as 1 by j into all these expressions are from SS signals and systems nunchi teeskuntunave ivanni. These are fundamental equations. Out of phase transfer function can be written as 1 by j into signum function minus 2 into complex of Westage function. Now, according to this, if we modify complex of H of F, according to this equation, that is complex of H of F can be written as in terms of HQ of F, that is quadrature function. What is our original complex H of F? Half into 1 plus signum function minus complex of Westage function. Westage transfer function. Already you know this expression. But signum function and complex of Westage function have odd functions. Therefore, they may have imaginary values. So, for that purpose, here we exist one new expression. That is HQF. What is HQF? It is a out of phase transfer function. That is quadrature transfer function. Now, if we rewrite the transfer function, complex transfer function, according to this value, according to this expression, then we have half into 1 plus J, quadrature function. just you substitute in place this one. If we write transfer function of h of f in terms of quadrature phase, then we have complex transfer function equal to half into 1 plus j into quadrature transfer function. Take the limitations as it is. Now already you know the relation between s of t and complex of s of t. In the previous topic also we take this expression. So what is the relation between normal signal and complex signal? It can be written as s of t equal to real part of re is nothing but real part of complex of s of t, complex of s of t into e power j 2 pi f c t. Already in the previous topic also we use this expression. Here what is s of t? S of t is a VSP modulated wave. So VSB modulated wave can be written as s of t equal to real part of complex s of t into e power j 2 pi f c t. So to calculate this s of t, first we know the parameter of complex s of t. So for that purpose, we take a complex s of f, that is frequency domain for this complex s of t, What is the frequency domain for complex s of t? Complex s of f. Ma, meeku ee parameter s of t find out cheyalante, first of all, you know the complex s of t value. So that is, first you know this parameter. How we know this parameter? By taking the frequency domain. So what is the frequency domain? Complex s of f equal to, from where we got the signal? VSB modulated wave. Ekkada nunchi vastundamma meeku? DSBSC nunchi vastundi. So therefore you take a complex frequency domain description for DSBSC. Take the DSBSC complex waveform into that signal is passed through shaping filter, which have the transfer function this one. Then we can relate those three parameters. We got complex function of s of f. So ikkada manaki final s of t kanukovalante, we must take the relation. What is that relation? Real part of complex s of t into e power j 2 pi f c t. But here our aim is calculation of this parameter. By knowing this parameter, if we substitute this parameter, then we got s of t. So how we can calculate this parameter? By taking the frequency domain. In frequency domain, what is the relation? Complex of h of f into DSBS is complex signal. ఎందుకని మనం ఇది తీసుకుంటున్నాము? ఎప్పుడైతే ప్రొడక్ట్ మాడ్యులేటర్ అవుట్పుట్ DSBS సిగ్నల్ వస్తుందో దాన్ని తీసుకొచ్చి మనం ఏ ఫిల్టర్లో పాస్ చేస్తున్నాము? వేవ్ షేపింగ్ ఫిల్టర్ విచ్ హావ్ ద ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ h of f. Therefore, our final frequency domain of s of f can be written as h of f into DSBSC signal. But what is complex function of DSBSC signal? 10 to 12 work. Opaganda. Already you know DSBSC signal complex signal is AC into M of F. You know this expression in DSBSC signal. After writing this expression, you write, but already we know DSBSC complex signal in frequency domain is AC into M of F. AC into M of F. Now substitute this value in the above expression. Then complex S of F can be written as complex H of F into AC into M of F. Now you also substitute complex H of F. What is complex H of F? According to this expression, we have half into 1 plus J into HQF. Now you substitute complex H of F also. Then complex S of F becomes half into AC into 1 plus J HQF into M of F. If we're converting into time domain, complex S of T becomes half AC into M of F, can be written as M of T plus, we multiply into this one, it becomes M of F plus J into HQ of F into M of F. If after multiplying, if you convert into time domain, it becomes M of T plus the quadrature function into M of F. If we convert into time domain, it becomes J into MQ of T. Now put this as equation number something. You write according to your convenience. Now substitute S cap of T. So that is complex of S of T in above expression. What is our expression? This is our expression, S of T. To find S of T, here we have complex of S of T. Now you substitute complex of S of T. So for that purpose, if we again take that expression or otherwise you represent with some number, equation number, then S of T equal to real part of, substitute complex S of T into, what is e power j theta? Cos theta plus j sin theta. So according to that, cos 2 pi f ct plus j sin 2 pi f ct. You convert this parameter. So therefore you can written as cos 2 pi f ct plus j sin 2 pi f ct. Then you multiply. So real part of. AC by 2 M of T into cos 2 pi f ct. Again, if you multiply this parameter into this one, J AC by 2 M of T into sin 2 pi f ct plus after multiplying, here we got four parameters. four parameters. What are that four parameters? So this one, this one, and this one. I think you multiplied. Now, if you consider real part, if you consider real part, so that is by neglecting imaginary parts, we have the first component, that is AC by 2 m of t into cos 2 pi of CT minus last component, that is AC by 2 mq of t into sin 2 pi of CT. Now, what is our S of t? What is our S of t? Common AC by 2, AC by 2 into m of t cos 2 pi of CT minus mq of t. It can also be written as m cap of t, m cap of t into sin 2 pi of CT, sin 2 pi of CT. Already in yesterday's class, we use this expression. So this is the time domain description for VSB signal. Time domain description for VSB signal. The main important key point here is, after generating of DSB SA signal, that DSB SA signal is passed through shape band filter, which have the transfer function of H of F, then we got VSB modulated wave. So for that purpose, you consider DSB SA signal and filter with transfer function H of F. So that is the main key point here. Now this is our VSB modulated wave. So this is when we, if we consider USB, this is the equation for, if we consider complete USB with wastage of LSB, with wastage of LSB. Similarly, if you write the expression for LSB, if we write the expression for LSB with wastage of USB, opposite case amma, LSB మొత్తం ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ చేస్తున్నాము, రీట్రేస్ ఆఫ్ అప్పర్ సైడ్ బ్యాండ్ పాస్ చేస్తున్నాము. ఇన్ దట్ సిచ్యువేషన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్? జస్ట్ చేంజ్ ద సైన్, యు జస్ట్ చేంజ్ ద సైన్ హియర్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఫర్ ఎల్ఎస్బి పాసింగ్ అండ్ వెస్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ యుఎస్బి, వెస్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ యుఎస్బి. So this is the time domain description for VSB signal. Now coming to advantages, it is very very important topic for short answers. What are the advantages for VSB? Already you know drawback of SSB, at lower frequencies that SSB is not suitable. But the main advantage of VSB is, at lower frequencies also we can easily transmit. There is no attenuation at lower frequencies, because here we perfectly isolate USB and LSB. We perfectly isolate USB and LSB. So for lower frequencies also, we can perfectly isolate USB and LSB. So therefore, without any attenuation, we can transmit low audio, low frequency signals. We can transmit low frequencies. Compared to DSB, bandwidth is also reduced. What is the bandwidth required for this VSB? It is also same as SSB. It is also same as SSB. SSB lo only single side band pass chestunnam. Ikkada em chestunnam manamu vestigial side band lo single side band ante upper side band gaani lower side band gaani complete ga pass chestunnamu. Some part of the lower side band ni pass chestunnamu. Kaani aa some part manam enta pass chestunnamu, mana upper side band lo kontha last part ni eliminate chestunnamu. Akkada last part entaithe eliminate avutundo, so మళ్ళీ రిమైనింగ్ పార్ట్ ఇటువైపు మనం పాస్ చేస్తున్నాం. సో టోటల్గా బ్యాండ్విడ్త్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఫర్ VSB ఇస్ సేమ్ యాజ్ ద బ్యాండ్విడ్త్ రిక్వైర్డ్ ఫర్ SSB. బట్ కంపేర్ టు DSB ఇట్ ఈస్ రెడ్యూస్డ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ రెడ్యూస్డ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ VSB. సో VSB సిగ్నల్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ ఈజీలీ జనరేట్ బై పాసింగ్ జస్ట్ త్రూ షేపింగ్ ఫిల్టర్స్. సో ద సర్క్యూట్ ఈస్ వెరీ simple, simple circuit. So these are the advantages of VSB. And comparison of, so up to this you completed all the techniques, AM, DSB, SSB, and VSB. Now, what is the last topic in our syllabus? The last topic is comparison of all techniques. So, amplitude modulation techniques, comparison of amplitude modulation techniques. So, it is very, very important topic. Just observe this table. Standard AM, standard AM, SSB, DSB, SC, VSB. Standard AM is nothing but conventional AM. Power required, already you know power calculations. Power required is very, very high. For SSB it is very less. For DSB, SC, since it pass only with two side bands with a suppressed carrier, so therefore the power required is medium. So for VSB, the power required is less than DSB-SC because in DSB-SC we pass double side bands, but in VSB we pass only single side band and retrace of another side band. So the power required for passing VSB is less than DSB-SC but greater than SSB. That is almost equal to SSB, almost equal to SSB. But comparatively for all the systems, the power required for SSB is very, very less since it requires only one sideband transmission. One sideband transmission. Now bandwidth. The bandwidth you already calculated for every technique. The bandwidth required. You write bandwidth required. Next, carrier suppression. So in the first technique only we pass the carrier. We pass the carrier, carrier suppression. There is no carrier suppression. But in SSB and DSB-SC, there is no carrier. So therefore, carrier suppression is done here. But in case of VSB, carrier is also passed. Carrier is also passed. So receiver complexity, if you observe the receiver complexity, for the first technique, it is very simple. And for DSB-SC and SSB, complex receivers are required. And for the last VSB, simple receivers are required. So write all these parameters. Once you observe these parameters, so sideband suppression, you're coming to sideband suppression, in which technique we have suppressed sideband. According to another parameter is efficiency. If you take efficiency, in which technique you got higher efficiency? You compare that parameter. Similarly, if you take applications, the first technique, normal AM, is used in radio communications. The second one, that is SSB, is used in point-to-point communications. That is for longer distances, mainly we use SSB. And for, we also sometimes use DSB-SC. But for television broadcasting, we prefer only VSB.